My name is Anthony Wanyoike. I'm the firstborn son to Lizzie Wanyoike, my mother. On the right, Stella and her sister, and Eric Kariuki Wanyoike. I'm going to read a tribute on behalf of my siblings. And I start. We are incredibly grateful in order to stand here today to share a little bit about our relationship with Mom. Coming from a humble background, she was determined to give us a better life, a better quality of life, but she made sure we kept our feet on the ground. She was determined to give us the best education that money could offer. Though we all, at one point, inserted our own will in those choices. For example, I was earmarked to attend St. Mary's School, but opted to attend Highway Secondary School. Stella chose to attend Musongari because she strongly wanted to pursue swimming, while Eric, at an early age, opted to attend boarding school, leaving my mom and dad a true empty nesters at an early age. It is when we were adults that we truly understood mom's character and personality, and particularly her generous spirit. Growing up, we were always in the company of our relatives from both sides of the family, be it our younger siblings, like my uncle who stood here for me, who were literally raised in the same home, or our cousins who would share rooms with us until they were sent to boarding schools. Our household was a continuous beehive of activity and should have it no other way. We also came to understand her love for her work and how it was an integral part of her. She is one of the very few individuals that we can talk about who truly lived her life with passion. She was fortunate and she was truly blessed by God. Whatever she put her hand to, she prospered. Most importantly, she worked hard and always led by example. Our mom was not one to stand over our heads, breathing down our throats at every time, issuing threats. She was a mom who talked to us and allowed us space to explore and learn for ourselves. We were all determined to live our very best lives because she had given us her very best. She had an uncanny sense for business. She was a true risk taker. She was a take it or leave it type of person. Someone who was willing to try and fail, but never willing to accept not trying. This is why she gave us each the opportunity to explore our careers, though we all knew her secret desire was to have us all working with her. She worked strategically to ensure that there was a position for each one of us, while throwing soft hints here and there. We chose to come back to join her in business, though we truly believed in her vision for this, because we truly believed in her vision for this country. Her true business was to grow and develop people. And this is a principle she always practiced. We are often told that we have a huge legacy to continue and that we have a big shoe to fill. We agree to this. What we can say here today, as we remember our dear mom, is that we will continue to endeavor to fulfill her vision for education, doing so in our own unique way. There is no way we could fit into her shoes by ourselves. We will need others like yourselves, those who have worked closely with Mom, those who have shown her favor and grace, and those who believe she is capable of anything, to jump in together to continue fulfilling her vision and her dreams. We will miss you, Mom. May you rest with the Lord in eternal peace. Thank you.
Amen. May the Lord continue strengthening you and giving you the grace to go through the moment. But for sure, even as you have said it, we believe that you have what it takes to take on the work that your mom had actually done.
Bwana asifiwe. God is good. And all the time, clergy, the family, and all the friends of Madam Lizzie Wanyoike. I greet you in the name of Jesus. My name is Joki Waburu, as I've been called out. And I'll be reading the tribute on behalf of the friends. Of course, bringing my condolences and that of my family. The reason as to why I have the confidence to read out this tribute is because I have had so many people share their experiences on how Madam Lizzie touched their lives, my being one. Mine will be short, and I read. No words enough to put on paper what and who you are in our different lives. No ink would even be enough to write it all. Again, no words would really put it together. As friends, we all have each a story and a beautiful experience. Not one, there are stories of how you impacted our lives in a big way. Your crown must be so beautiful and so colorful, decorated with life. Changing moments in different or in many of us. Some of our lives radiates with the impact that you made in our lives. And what if you only were to live a little longer? Maybe a year, or 5, or even to 100. But well, God picked the best. And he's too God. Yes, he's too God to be questioned. Your legacy lives in our lives. For now we say good night. See you in the morning on that beautiful shore. It is well.